Welcome to Monday with Michelle and Outlate But Great, coming to you a little later today because I had so much stuff to do today, and then I realized I forgot my Outlate But Great video, which I usually do earlier in the afternoon. So I'm sitting out here on my deck. Let me turn this camera around. Oh, I don't know if I can do that. I guess I can't turn it around midstream. Let's see if we can do this way. I have a little, my earth boxes are started here. And got eggplant and kale. And there's my green drink that I'm finishing up. Looks appetizing, huh? And just enjoying. It's a little cool out here still. Cool for our standards, though, because it's like, I don't know, like 70 or something. Now it's probably like 68. And so I'm watching the, see the squirrel over there, I hope you can. And the birds come and eat the peanuts and everything. Okay, so Jim from Ohio gave us our topic this week, and it's all about senior LGBT people and what they have had to go through in relation to what we are going through now. And like he said in his, you can look below for the description, but he said, you know, it's definitely not a picnic for us, but it certainly was no picnic for them, you know, growing up and having to live in the last, you know, 60 or 70 years if they're that old. And so I know of some LGBT older people, but I've never had the discussion with them about this. So I do have a bit of happy news about someone that I do know. I think he's got to be around 70, and his partner's probably a little bit younger than him, but they've been together for decades and decades, and just a couple months ago flew to Hawaii and got married, which is really, really cool because, you know, they've been living unmarried, you know, all this time, but now that they're able to talk about, you know, just having that validation and now being able to take advantage of things that they couldn't even dream about before. And so I'm sure that a lot of the older LGBT people who are still around and who still have a partner are very grateful for all the laws that are changing, because now they are coming into that time where they may be going into a retirement home or need some kind of nursing facility, and all those laws will most certainly be in their favor. And so I wish that I had somebody that I could actually interview about, you know, how they felt having to live this whole time as gay without feeling exactly comfortable in society. And I'm sure that they are grateful that those of us who are now coming out and living in society, especially today's youth, that they don't have to go through the same things that they went through. And it's just really, really good that things have changed so much. And they are the ones that have paved the path for us because they were true to themselves no matter what society said, and no matter what they felt that they may have to endure in order to be themselves. But I would imagine that a lot of older LGBT people would tell you that they have been heavily closeted, and if not, maybe just the friends and immediate family, you know, close people to them are the ones that knew, and that was probably about it. Because they probably feared, you know, society's rejection. And maybe also, it was kind of one of these unspoken things, you know. It's like, for those of us who are, you know, around my age, you know, we always had, like, those teachers in school or those professors in college that we knew, you know. We just had a gut feeling. But it was never really talked about. And, you know, it was kind of one of those assumed things. So hopefully the others will be able to answer this a little bit better than I was able to. And I hope wherever you are that the weather is starting to warm up a little bit for you. And I'm just really grateful that I'm sitting out here on my back deck and just being able to, you know, not be freezing my butt off. All right, you guys, have a terrific week, and I'll talk to you soon.